When you think of how to stop a major disease outbreak, you're probably thinking of a scene from a medical thriller where a world-renowned virologist is helicoptered out in a race against time to find the person who's the source of the infection, the patient zero. Patient zero isn't just a Hollywood creation. It's a real thing in the medical community, and it defines the first carrier of a disease in an outbreak. Identifying the origin of a disease helps scientists understand and prevent future pandemics. These things have to start somewhere, right? But figuring out who patient zero is requires a great deal of detective work. Health experts go out into the field and they map the transmission of a virus. They follow a molecular game of telephone called contact tracing, which involves searching for everyone who came into contact with a sick patient. According to an epidemiologist we spoke to, it's helpful to find out how a virus travels through a community. It's a way to classify the disease as airborne or foodborne, for instance, and to work on a vaccine. Though movies tell kind of a different story. Finding patient zero isn't as big a deal as preventing an outbreak from spreading. Plus, searching for the scapegoat in situations like this can easily turn into a public witch hunt, which isn't great. For example, back in the 1980s, during the height of the AIDS epidemic, researchers at the CDC interviewed several HIV patients looking for the source of the infection. They constructed a network of 40 infected men. All 40 were connected to one gay airline flight attendant who was then vilified and dubbed patient zero of the AIDS epidemic by the media. But it wasn't that guy. Later genetic analysis found HIV had been floating around the United States throughout the 1970s, evolving within different hosts for years. Science exonerated him, and in fact, he's so not patient zero. A separate genetic analysis found the actual patient zero has roots that go all the way back to chimps in Africa. People were slaughtering them for their meat, exposing themselves to the HIV virus. Which is common. Many diseases start in animals and then move over to humans, otherwise known as spillover. MERS came from camels, SARS from bats, and H5N1 or bird flu from birds. When they come in contact with humans, a disease is considered zoonotic and can be very deadly. But to bring it back to finding patient zero, remember, epidemiologists want to contain an outbreak, not find someone to blame. But this is why the process of shoe leather epidemiology is a big deal. Scientists go out and they find who did what, when, and where. It's very much like a detective novel for the path of a disease. Finding wider connections is important because of something called the 20-80 rule. Basically, 20% of a population causes 80% of infections. That 20% does have a name, superspreaders. Superspreaders are the ones who make a virus go viral. The SARS and Ebola outbreaks both had superspreaders. That flight attendant was very likely a superspreader. In 2011, there was an outbreak of methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus, or MRSA, a superbug, in a baby ward. By using fast genome sequencing technology, a team of researchers were able to work quickly to trace the source to a staff member who was unwittingly carrying the strain and infecting patients. They are not patient zero, but at that point the PZ didn't matter. The outbreak was contained. Let's face it, looking for patient zero can be difficult and problematic because there's really no way to actually observe that moment when a patient becomes patient zero. It's really more of a good theory with the best evidence we've got at the time. But with new computer simulations, genetic tracking, and good old-fashioned detective work, health workers can find super spreaders who really drive the epidemic, putting a stop to a disease before it spreads further. Disease eradication is a seriously difficult business, but we've done it. Haven't we, kind of? We eradicated smallpox. Find out how in this blast from the past here. Why was I in a sweater? What's with that hair? Ooh. What's your favorite movie about the spread of infections? Let us know down in the comments. Please subscribe so you get more Seeker. I once went on a date to see Contagion. We shook hands and we never saw each other again. Anyway, thanks for watching.